I discovered that Fisher information is a very interesting object, but there is not very much explicit computation of Fisher information. So I spend a lot of time to write concrete example where you can compute the Fisher information. And doing this, I discovered a very elegant inequality of Abraham Kagan. Abraham Kagan is still in Maryland. He is 86 and is in a good shape. So I'm going to explain. So I have 20 minutes, isn't it?
Yes.
First of all, what is Fisher information in simple word? What are, since the Kagan inequality relies on one of my favorite topics, exponential families, so I'm going to explain a few things about exponential families and finally the Kagan inequality itself. Of course, this is not extremely original talk, but actually the paper by Kagan is not quite easy to read, and I can tell you that I have spent several days before understanding what it means. I'm not sure that even mentioned all the hypotheses. So the main thing is the fact that we are dealing with curved exponential families. And the curved exponential families, to my opinion, are horrible objects because they have absolutely no properties. You have something which is called natural or general exponential families, but curved are a kind of ugly object. But actually, this is a subject of Kagan, and I'm going to give details. So, well, what is a Fisher model? The Fisher model, I'm going to take things in a simple way. So you start from measure space, omega nu, and you consider a function L of W of theta, where theta is a connected open subset of RD. This is a parameter. So I'm writing the probability in that way. Usually, this is not written like this. In most of the books, you have nu is a Lebesgue measure, and f under exponential is f of w on theta with many complicated conditions because f should be zero, not be zero. So I prefer to explain the things such that the function is never zero. So you can take its logarithm. So I am assuming that L of omega is twice continuously differentiable, and of course that this measure is a probability. Of course, since this is a probability, the integral is one. So this proves that the function nu and Lw, the pair, is not completely arbitrary because they are linked between these two things. So so we differentiate in good circumstances. You can find in the books a very complicated condition that assumes that these complicated conditions are fulfilled. And if you differentiate this, you get exactly this simple formula. This function L prime is the important object. They call it usually the score function. So this is the score function for theta, which is fixed. This is a random variable of RD, because you have a differential. L is a real function defined on of theta in RD. So this is a gradient. So this is a vector. So L prime of theta is a center random variable value in RD. And so the Fisher information is nothing but the covariance of this. You consider this as a random variable with respect to p theta, for fixed theta. And then you get the Fisher information, which is this covariance, which is interesting to mention, and everybody mentioned it. This is the fact that, let me come back to the previous slide. If you differentiate this, you are going to, with respect to theta, you are going to differentiate L prime of theta cross L prime of theta. This is a, and then you have a second differential. And you get L prime. So you get this sum. The sum of this is still zero. And that one part of the sum is exactly the Fisher information. So we have a second representation of the Fisher information with the Hessian matrix of L prime. So nothing really new, but this is a way to present it. What happens to the Fisher information when you move the initial parameter theta? You replace by a new parameter lambda with lambda value in RK with K smaller than Z. So we of course assume that theta is differentiable. So we have to imagine theta prime as a matrix with size D and K. And the new Fisher model is that with this definition of Q lambda. As a Fisher model, it has also a Fisher information, and you pass from the Fisher information, the old one, with the new one, simply by taking this matrix, IP, and you multiply by the two suitable matrices. Okay, this is what happened for Fisher information when you do a change of variable. The important case would be when lambda is when k is equal to one. A few things about exponential families. An exponential family to me is a positive measure mu on the Euclidean space. We consider the important object, the Laplace transform, the set where d mu, where the Laplace transform is finite. Hölder inequality shows that this domain is convex, and the function k mu is also a convex function on D. And you forget about the boundaries. We take the interior of this convex set, and you assume this interior is not empty, of course. And we assume that mu is not concentrated on a fine hyperplane to avoid trivialities. For instance, in one dimension, you have to assume this is not concentrated on one point. Okay, so the set of measures with such a property, we are calling it M of RD, the measures which have a good Laplace transform and which are not concentrated on a too small hyperplane. With this condition is now strictly convex. So strictly convex, if you differentiate a convex function which is strictly convex, the gradient is injective, and this is a very important property. The natural exponential family is this model, exponential theta x minus k. This is the natural exponential family. Alors, what is the Fisher information of the natural exponential family? Of course, this is very easy to compute, and this is exactly the Hessian matrix. The Hessian matrix, which is actually also the covariance matrix. The covariance matrix on the Fisher matrix when the parameter is theta are coincide. So we have a very simple calculation in this case. Now, we can talk sometimes of general exponential families. So general exponential families, you simply you start from an abstract space, measure space, and you map this space to RD, and finally you consider, you assume that the image of the measure nu is in RD, and then you have the general exponential family on an abstract space. But this is not extremely, so this is the model. This is not an extremely interesting object because if you consider the image mu of nu by this map, you call it the associated natural exponential family, and all the interesting properties of the general exponential families depend actually on the natural exponential families which is associated to it. Now, curve exponential families, but the curve exponential family, you simply you start from a general exponential family, and you choose an interval t. You choose an interval I, and a map from this interval to the set of parameters, and so finally this is what the set of parameters is concentrated actually on a curve. This is the source of this denomination. Now. What is the Kagan inequality? The Kagan inequality consider a curve exponential families, and I'm going to eliminate the artificial role of the general exponential families, and it does not make a big difference. So this is the inequality. You consider an exponential family, RD. Let me call it G, G of theta. Generated by mu. And you consider also an open interval and a smooth from t to theta t. Therefore, you create a curve exponential family from the natural one. Another important object, you consider a completely different Fisher model, f on rd, defined by ft of dy, nu dy, another measure. This is a Fisher model, no relation with KMU, not yet. Such that mu and nu are absolutely continuous with respect to each other. And now, for fixed t, you call x the pt coming from the exponential family, y ft coming from the Fisher, and you assume that they have the same first and second moments. I have written this in that way. This is not the covariance, but since the equality are equal, so that then the remarkable thing of Kagan is the fact that the Fisher model has always bigger information than the curve exponential family. This equality equality for all t implies that IP equal to IF. Okay. So let me show the proof. How much time? 5 minutes? Okay, that's good. So without loss of generality, I can assume that mu equal to nu. Because if you change a Fisher model a little bit, you replace by an absolutely continuous other, you change the measure nu, you get the same thing. So the score function does not is not modified. So the idea, you fix t on I. And now you consider the two inverse space, L2 of pt and L2 of ft. They are real function on RT. And we are introducing two subspaces of dimension d plus one each. the one generated by the constant function and one and x1 xz and in the space of L2 ft h1. Okay. The fact the two subspaces hi and hy, the fact that the moments for x are the same implies that the two spaces hx and hy are of course isometric. Now we introduce a score function. The score function for the Fischer model, L prime of t, this integral is zero. We can claim that since L prime of t is zero, there exists a number A and a function C such that C is orthogonal to hy. So L prime of t, you express it as a linear combination of element of hy and the orthogonal part. Yeah. The point is A1 is this vector A is exactly theta prime. For this, you observe that k prime of theta and implies that this equality, and since x, y, expectation of x and y are the same, you get this. Now, the important point, we have, up to now, we have fixed t. Now, the trick is to move t now. And so we take the above equality, we take derivative. So you take derivative, you get k second estimating theta prime, which is this expectation, and that you write since in the way that we have written L prime, and you get this equality. And this equality is nothing but the covariance of y computed on the vector A. And since the covariance of x is the same, this is also A. Now, k second is the covariance of x. Then k second of theta t is the covariance of x, pt, and therefore we have this equality. Since G was a natural exponential family, this matrix is invertible. And you can simplify. You can simplify here, and you get theta prime equal to A. This is the trick of Kagan. Finally, you get IF. You write I the Fischer information. You write it in two parts by the above decomposition, and you have this part on the orthogonal part. And that you can rewrite in that way in terms of y, but since y and x have the same moments, you can rewrite it in that way. But this covariance of x is nothing but the exponential, the Fischer information. And so since this quantity is positive, you get the Kagan inequality. Okay, so maybe, so if equality occurs for one t, c equal to zero, if equal to, for all t, I mean c of t equal to zero, then we have this for all t, and taking a primitive of the right hand side is this, and you get exactly p equal to f. So I can just sketch an example. Can I? No. Well, the example that can offer is the hyperbolic, the exponential family is a hyperbolic distribution of Morris, So with this kind of density generated by this measure, so you can make the calculation, and as you with the curve exactly theta equal to t, and you as another example, you the Fisher model that you take for creating an example, you take the Fisher model, which is normal with the same mean as this one. You can easily compute the mean, and with the same covariance, you can, of course, design a Fisher model with given a function of t with a mean depending on t and the same covariance depending on t, and then you get an interesting inequality, which is from this example. So I mentioned in the paper a multidimensional example comparing non-central Wishart on the Wishart, but this is much more complicated. Thank you.
We will reduce the question because we are late, 10 minutes late. So thank you to Professor Letac for this talk.